The words, "find your brother," kept reoccurring in my mind. I had to get to Shaheer. Right at that moment, my friend got up in a state of complete panic. A man with a rifle chasing him. The bullet had left the gun and gone into my friend's innocent heart. As he fell to the floor, he dragged me down with him. And right before his heart stopped, he covered my face with his hand. The man with the rifle stopped firing in our direction and moved to another area of the school. They thought I too was dead alongside my buddy. I could not get myself to move, to get up and look for my brother. I could not even breathe because the fear and the pain paralyzed all my senses.
तकरीबन कोई सवा दस दस बीस के करीब इनका फ़ोन आया सुबह. मैं किचन में काम कर रही थी. इनका फ़ोन आया तो मुझे कहने लगे कि शगुफ्ता उस पर ना अटैक हो गया स्कूल में. मैंने कहा ताहिर अल्लाह खैर करेगा, अल्लाह खैर करेगा, कौन घुसाया? मैं कहा कितने बंदे हैं? कहते कुछ पता नहीं, यहाँ पर अटैक हो गया, बस बस तुम दुआ करो ना. तो फिर इन्होंने, जब मैंने उनको ये बात कही, तो उसके कोई 15-20 मिनट के बाद फिर मेरा दिल बहुत शदीद धड़का है, बहुत घबराया मेरा दिल ना. मैंने दोबारा इन्हें कॉल बैक किए. फिर मैंने कहा है कि आप मुझे बताएं कि अब क्या पोजीशन है ना. तो कहते हैं कि फिर ये आगे से रो रहे, मतलब इस तरह नहीं नहीं मैं रोहांसू वाली ना, मतलब कि फूल के भी नहीं रो रहे, रोहांसू हुए मैं बिल्कुल. नहीं नहीं बस तुम दुआ करो, दुआ करो, यहाँ पर बहुत फायरिंग हो रही है. 2:30 बजे के बाद आया मुनीब. मैंने मुनीब को कहा कि मुनीब आप आ गए. मुनीब भी मुझे खाली नज़रों से, अब मुझे सारी चीज़ें वो थी. अल्लाह ये कितना बेचारे का जहन उस टाइम वो था कि मैंने इसको इसकी तरफ ध्यान ही नहीं दिया. ये आया तो बस मैंने कहा मुनीब शुक्र है तुम आ गए हो. मैंने मुनीब को ऐसे करके पकड़ा है, मुझे शुक्र है खैरियत से. मुनीब को ऐसे करके मैंने देखा है, शुक्र अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह खैरियत से. मैंने कहा मुनीब खाना खाओ आप, इसकी बहन को कहा बेटे अब इसे खाना ला के दो. मुनीब ने इसको ला के खाना बहन ने दिया, लेकिन इसने खाना नहीं खाया. इसकी हालत ऐसी थी कि ये खाना नहीं खा सका. इसकी बहन ने भी नहीं खाया, खाना बना हुआ था. मैंने कहा बेटे आप लोग खाना खाओ, फिर शहीर को ढूंढ रहे हैं, पता चलता है.
As the men left our school, I got up from the floor in the middle of a bloodbath around me. I walked through the school in a daze, looking for my brother. When I entered his classroom, I could see the story unfold. Shaheer had panicked, ran across the room, bumped into the desk, and had several bullets pierce various parts of his body. He had fallen forward and was lying face down right by the exit door. He was dead. My only brother was dead, and I could not find the courage to chase his murderers. I had stayed still under my friend's hand to survive, and now I would let the guilt of my beating heart kill me instead. I should have been there to protect him, to save him, but I had been too petrified to be useful.
बकरीद जिस दिन हमारे यहाँ पर बकरीद मनाई गई है, तो हम लोग जानवर लेके आए, बैल खरीदा था हमने. सारे हम लोग बाहर मैदान में ही एहतमाम करते हैं, वहीं पर ही ज़िबा करते हैं. मुझे कुछ ख्याल नहीं रहा और मुनीब भी मेरे साथ ही खड़े थे. तो जिस वक्त बैल को हमने ज़िबा किया, तो थोड़ी देर बाद मुझे कुछ ख्याल आया कि मुनीब जो है ना वो बिल्कुल फेंट हो गया. मैंने उसको कहा मुनीब क्या बात है, अब इसके मुँह से ना आवाज़ नहीं निकल रही. और उधर जो बैल था, वो जब आखिरी स्टेज होती है, जिस तरीके से वो अपना ब्लड बाहर फेंक रहा होता है, ये बिल्कुल ट्रॉमा की चीज़ की पोजीशन हो गई और ये वहाँ से भाग करके ऊपर आ गया.
यही वो basically قربانی کے دن پہ اس کو جب وہاں پہ کھڑا کیا ڈیڈی نے اپنے ساتھ تو جب جانور کو کی قربانی ہو رہی تھی تو وہ جب جس طرح سے وہ ان کے اندر سے آوازیں آ رہی تھیں تو ان آوازوں میں سے اس نے نا اپنے کانوں میں انگلیاں ڈال لیں انگلیاں ڈالنے کے بعد نا ہی واز لائک ڈیڈی نے اس کو نوٹ ہی نہیں کیا کہ اس کے ساتھ ہو کیا رہا ہے کہیں میرے اوپر اس کی کوئنسیڈنٹلی نظر پڑ گئی یہ آیا گھبرا کے اوپر واپس میرے پاس گھر آیا اور گھر آ کے اس کے اوپر وہی ڈپریشن پی ڈی ایس ٹی کی سچویشن اس کے اوپر کریٹ ہو گئی واز لائک ہی لاکڈ ہم سیلف فار آلموسٹ 5 to 6 hours
The Army Public School tragedy not only shook the world, but through a ripple effect, it affected everybody, including myself as a professional psychiatrist. Since that tragedy, I've been involved in the care of several students and their respective families who have been very bravely dealing with the aftermath of that tragedy. And therefore, in my experience, when we provide an intervention, support, help, rehabilitation process for young adolescents who are going through PTSD reactions, that is when they start to respond very well. Remember, there are no drugs, in fact, that can treat it. It has to be an extensive, well thought out, creative, scientific rehabilitation process for them.
They attacked all the students and teachers, wounded and killed many of those I held near and dear to my life. I lost my brother, Shaheer, during that act of violence because I was unable to help him or save him in time. I arrived back at my home in a state of delusion and stupor that night. I had started the day with my brother by my side and came back home never to see him again. Every time I closed my eyes, I encountered disturbing thoughts of that day. Violence, blood and gore became normal to look at, and I became immune to watching others die. You could almost call me a sadist, because I think I actually began to enjoy inflicting pain upon others. There were times I even felt like I wanted to kill those that made me angry, just as the terrorists had slaughtered my brother.
Also, what is extremely important is to understand that this guilt phenomena that Muneeb, as the elder brother of Shaheer, is going through is something that I've seen working with young adolescents for the last decade and a half. I've seen several of these young boys experiencing what they call a survivor's guilt. When they're younger ones, their sisters, their brothers, their family members are killed, fall martyr, or are wounded as a consequence of a terrorist attack or a bombing. They feel that why couldn't they help them? Why couldn't they rescue them? Why couldn't they be in their place? And these reactions are called a survivor's guilt, but I think it's a very strong word. In that sense of the word. Again, we need to start to see this survivor's guilt as an absolutely normal psychological reaction.
Amidst the devastation started the media circus. Recaps of the attack, journalist interviews with victims, the school's next plan of action in order to prevent future attacks. None of this mattered to me. My tragedy had already occurred and there was no changing it. My best friend and brother was gone forever. I would never be the same happy-go-lucky Muneeb again.
Ye vatan tumhara hai Tum ho paas baas ke Ye chaman tumhara hai تم ہو نغمہ خالص کے
I saw that many families, especially those with children, were slowly but surely moving away from our town. None of the citizens of our country wanted to be in Peshawar any longer, as it was now the home of a national tragedy. All the schools in the area put barbed wire fences around their buildings and metal detectors at their entrance. Students had to walk through them before entering. It was the only way to create a sense of safety, however false it might be in the region. Inside the school, everyone, teachers and students alike, were being taught how to defend themselves against people with guns. Self-defense was now a core class due to living conditions. And it made me wonder why. Why was Peshawar obligated to take so many security measures? Why couldn't we, the citizens and civilians, have the freedom we are entitled to? Why must we be checked everywhere we go? I often saw kids my age on television. They were in other countries, and they did not have to live their lives the way we did. They were free to walk, talk, and play without being frisked and questioned. Their freedom made me green with envy. I wanted the kids of my country to live the way those kids on TV did. And I knew that something had to change for that to occur. My name is Muneeb. I was born and raised in Peshawar, Pakistan, with my parents, two sisters, and my late brother Shaheer. My mother was a housewife, and my father had a small electronics store in the bazaar. Being a middle-class family, we had limited sources of affordable entertainment. Therefore, my brother and I would come home from school every day and play combat video games in which we had to hide from terrorists, divert their attention, and eventually take them down with the animated weaponry and ammunition in the game.
ये जो सुंदर सा हमारा रूम होता है एक एफपीएस जो गेम होती है ना इधर से बाहर और यहां गन नजर आ रही होती है बस इसी तरह की
तो तुम मुझे बताओ ये कि तुम यहां पे खेलोगे आज के से बाहर जाकर खेलोगे
यार अगर यहां बन जाए तो बहुत अच्छी बात है
नहीं तो तुमने ये रूम
बनाने में क्या
है
डिजाइन क्यों नहीं हो रही है
तुम्हें से क्या फायदा मिलेगा भाई
फेंसिंग और डिफेंसिंग हो रही है ना देखो कितनी अच्छी ट्रेनिंग है एक तरीके से बस नॉर्मल सी गन्स हैं बस खेलने वाली
सपोर्ट कौन करेगा
सपोर्ट कौन
करेगा नहीं मतलब तुम इसको बना लोगे तो तुम्हारे लिए इसके ऊपर तुम्हें कौन अप्रिशिएट करेगा तुम्हारी शिप्स के लिए तुम्हारे साथ कौन खड़ा होगा
क्यों ही खड़े होंगे
कौन खड़े होंगे पाकिस्तान में उसका स्कोप ही नहीं है भाई
स्कोप भरे लोग आएंगे देखेंगे तो पता चलेगा ना
नहीं होगा
अगर हो गया
अगर ना हुआ तो तुम फेल हो गए तो मुझे क्या
The year I spent trying to understand what had happened that fateful day helped me realize two important aspects of my personality. One, I knew how to move without being noticed and how to discreetly hide from those chasing me due to the video games. They had taught me various combat skills, how to react in situations of terror, and given me an ability to read my surroundings quickly and effectively. I only wished that my brother had been old enough to implement what he had learned alongside me. And two, my post-traumatic stress from seeing my peers die was in direct correlation to my sudden fascination with violence, blood, and sadism. The only relief I found from this frenzy was to play the games that Shaheer and I used to, and defeat the animated version of the rifled men. In the gaming world, I was able to take down my brother's murderers and save his character. In the gaming world, I could diminish my regrets and ease my pain.
Muneeb ki aur Shaheer ki aapas mein badi dosti ji. Ye school se aane ke baad mera khayal hai mushkil se ye baste rakhte the aur inki aapas mein na kushti shuru ho jati thi jaise bhaiyon mein hoti hai. ماں ان کو واضح دے رہی ہیں کہ بھائی جاؤ جا کر کے پہلے نہا لو اور اس کے بعد آ کر کے کھانا کھا لو. تو کھانا اور نہانا تو ایک سائڈ پر, لیکن مار دھاڑ شروع ہے کمرے کے اندر. میں تو صبح کا گیا ہوا شام کو گھر آتا تھا, تو مجھے ان کی والدہ رپورٹ دیتی تھی کہ بھائی آج انہوں نے یہ کیا ہے, آج انہوں نے یہ کیا ہے, آج انہوں نے یہ کیا ہے.
اس حادثے کے بعد منیب کو جب بہت زیادہ سائیکولوجیکل ایشوز اسٹارٹ ہوئے, تو ایک ڈاکٹر آئی ہوئی تھی اس کی سائیکولوجیکل ٹریٹمنٹ کے لیے. اس نے ان سے اپنی یہ بات ڈسکس کی تھی کہ مجھے اس چیز کا بہت زیادہ گلٹ ہے کہ میں اپنے بھائی کو بچا نہیں پایا. اٹس بیکاز اس کے اندر یہ گلٹ آہستہ آہستہ اس طرح سے ڈیولپ ہوا کہ کوئی بھی اس طرح کا ایونٹ ہوتا ہے تو کانفلکچوئل جو باتیں ہوتی ہیں وہ بہت زیادہ انوائرمنٹ جو ہے وہ انوائرمنٹ میں آنے لگتی ہیں. وہ یہ ہوا کہ اس نے یہ باتیں اسٹارٹ کر دیں کہ شہیر منیب کو بچانے کے لیے ہال سے باہر آیا تھا, حالانکہ دیٹ واز ناٹ دا ریالٹی, ریالٹی واز سم تھنگ ایلس. یہ باتیں جب اتنی انوائرمنٹ میں اتنی زیادہ اسٹارٹ ہوئیں تو اس کو اس چیز کا یہ ہونے لگا, آلریڈی اس کے دل میں تھا کہ وہ ہال میں تھا میں اس کو دیکھ نہیں پایا. جب یہ بات اس کے دل میں آئی کہ اچھا وہ میرے لیے آیا تھا اور وہ میری وجہ سے چلا گیا, تو وہ ان چیزوں سے اپنے آپ کو نکال نہیں پایا.
ہاں, میں نے منیب کو کہا, مجھے کہنے لگا ڈیڈی کہ میں تو آ گیا ہوں اور شہیر جو ہے نا وہ ہال کے اندر ہے اور میں اس کو بچا سکتا تھا. میں نے کہا نہیں, یہ آپ کی غلط سوچ ہے, آپ اس کو بچا نہیں سکتے تھے, بچانے والی ذات جو ہے نا وہ اوپر اللہ ہے. اور اس آپ نے بڑی عقل مندی کی کہ آپ نکل آئے. شہیر آپ سے چھوٹا تھا, اس کی اتنی عقل نہیں, اس کا اتنا تجربہ نہیں, اور آپ کے اوپر یہ چیز لاگو نہیں ہوتی کہ آپ نے اپنے بھائی کو ضروری بچانا تھا. آپ کوئی کمانڈو تو نہیں ہے, آپ کوئی فوج میں تو آپ کا تعلق نہیں, آپ نے کوئی اسپیشل ٹریننگ تو نہیں لی ہوئی. یہ تو بیٹے ایک ایسا گیم کھیلا گیا ان بچوں کے ساتھ, ایک ایسی کہ جس میں آپ کو اللہ پاک نے بچا دیا, آپ اللہ کا شکر ادا کریں. آپ اپنے بھائی کے موت کے ذمہ دار نہیں, آپ نہ سمجھیں کہ یار میں اپنے بھائی کو بچا لیتا, نہیں ایسا نہیں ہے. بچانے والی ذات صرف اور صرف وہ اللہ کی ہے اور اللہ پہ توکل کرنا چاہیے.
یس آئی ایم ڈپریسڈ, یس آئی ایم ڈومڈ, یس آئی ایم اسکیئرڈ فار دا ریسٹ آف مائی لائف. آئی ریئلائز نو ڈاکٹر اور سائیکائٹرسٹ آن دس پلانٹ کین ہیلپ می بٹ مائی سیلف الون. I spent a lot of time locked inside my room, reanalyzing my post-attack life. I couldn't foresee a light of hope while being in that condition. There was a part of me suppressed by my fears deep down. They're shouting that something got to change. One day, while sitting all by myself, I decided to listen to that shout. That shout that said, "Let's find a way to fix it." I tried suppressing it again, but since I already allowed it to enter the cerebrum, it refused to go away. Fix it. Fix it. Fix it. This kept echoing inside my head.
What happens here is that an individual who's traumatized, who's at one point is constantly distressed and anguished with his old wounds, he licks them every day and he is distressed and anguished. In that same psychological traumatized state, there is a part of him that has grown spiritually. He becomes a different person, a bigger person, a person who wants to rediscover himself, who wants to become a greater individual.
I realized that in order to overcome these thoughts, I had to find my purpose for living. I had to justify being alive to ease the guilt of my survival. It was time to temporarily move away from Peshawar, recollect myself and find a new purpose. Instead of choosing a socially acceptable subject for study, the decision to pursue game design and visual arts from an art school away from Peshawar was now set in stone.
شہیر کے حادثے کے بعد منیب بہت زیادہ چینج ہو گیا ہے. اس مجھے ایسا لگتا ہے کہ اس کے سارے ڈیسیجنس شہیر کے خوابوں کے ارد گرد گھوم رہے ہیں. میں اپنے ایک بھائی کے بعد دوسرے کو نہیں دور کر سکتی, اور میری امی تو زیادہ نہیں بولتی لیکن میں جانتی ہوں وہ اپنے ایک بیٹے کے بعد دوسرے کو اپنے آپ سے دور نہیں کر پائیں گی.
ہمارا میرے بچے جو ہیں شہیر اور یہ منیب کو ایک بیٹا میرا رہ گیا، حالانکہ بیٹیاں بھی میری دو ہی ہیں، لیکن میں اس کو منیب کو بھی پڑھائی کے سلسلے میں بھائی نے کہا اس کو باہر بھیج دو، تم چلو تم نہیں آ رہی اسی کو باہر بھیج دو، تم یہ پڑھ لے گا وہاں پر آ کے، تو تب بھی مجھے نہیں، میں بالکل ہی زیادہ اس طرح سے رہی کہ نہیں میں اس کو کیسے بھیج دوں، تو میں یہاں کیا کروں اس کے بغیر، اس کو دیکھ کے ہی ہم جسے کہتے ہیں نا جیتے بھی ہیں، میں کہتی ہوں جو کچھ بھی ہے بس اپنے ملک میں رہ کے کر لو.
When a Muneeb decides to become a software engineer who's going to make a special kind of a program to help individuals fight back terrorists, he's symbolically describing and telling the world, come help me, take me along and I'll show what I can do for you. I think that's where the world needs to realize its responsibility and start to embrace Muneeb as a citizen of the world and just not of Pakistan, and open the doors for Muneebs of Pakistan so that they can contribute through the phenomena of post-traumatic growth that they are experiencing.
Pakistan jaise mulk mein visual arts ka I don't think so ki koi such a scope hai jo mera bhai جس کے لیے وہ اتنا زیادہ اس کو کریز ہوا ہوا ہے کہ وہ یہ کرنا سب چاہتا ہے. میری مدر میرا نہیں خیال کہ اس کو کبھی بھی اس چیز کے لیے الاؤ کریں گی. اور اے پی ایس جیسا انسیڈنٹ فار دا ویری فرسٹ ٹائم ان دا ہسٹری یہ ایسا ایونٹ ہوا ہے جس سے کچھ فیملیز گزری ہیں اور ہر بندہ اس تکلیف کو محسوس نہیں کر سکتا. میری مدر اس انسیڈنٹ کے بعد کبھی بھی اس کو اتنا اپنے سے دور نہیں جانے دیں گی.
I believe that video games that demonstrate these crucial tactics are an integral part of every child's upbringing and fundamental to rehabilitating those who have been mentally destroyed by the violence in Pakistan. It is essential that the public have this knowledge as they are basic survival skills in Pakistan's environment. I aspire to design video games that teach kids and adults combat strategies against attacks and coping mechanisms after having been through traumatic events. I feel by creating these combat games and trying to help prevent what happened to Shaheer from happening to anyone else's loved one, I am giving honor to my late brother's memory and redeeming myself in his eyes and in the eyes of my God. The guilt I have felt since the attack has pushed me to strive to find my purpose. With this degree from your university and my ambition to change the way my country thinks, I desire to rehabilitate myself as well and one day have a heart that is not so heavy. I dream to make a difference in the lives of Pakistan's youth, and it can only be facilitated with admission into your infamous arts program. I hope my vision and my story inspires you enough to let me be a part of your university's history.
The world needs to realize that these young Pakistanis, these Shaheers and Muneebs of Pakistan, had no direct enmity with the terrorist. The terrorist has used them as a target to make a statement against the world that they believed did not deal with them properly. So they have been, therefore, they have become a symbol of the hatred that the terrorists had for the world. I think the world needs to start to realize that these Shaheers and these Muneebs need to be now taken up by the world with open arms. They need to be embraced with open arms. When a Muneeb decides to become a software engineer who's going to make a special kind of a program to help individuals fight back terrorists, he's symbolically describing and telling the world, come, help me. Take me along and I'll show what I can do for you. I think that's where the world needs to realize its responsibility and start to embrace Muneeb as a citizen of the world and just not of Pakistan, and open the doors for Muneebs of Pakistan so that they can contribute through the phenomena of post-traumatic growth that they're experiencing. And we also need to remember that if the world shuts its doors and it is behaving no different than the initial terrorist who attacked them, because this time the world would not injure their body, but probably would kill their spirit.